COVID-19 epidemic versus endemic. Scientists warn it would always be epidemic. Some say that COVID-19 will soon be endemic, a fancy way to say it is here to stay. But not everyone agrees with the notion. Some consider that COVID-19 to be constantly an epidemic. So what does it mean for the public? Endemic, epidemic, and pandemic may sound the same for many people. However, there are major differences. Let's start with endemic, where a disease is found in a particular place or people. Next is an epidemic, where a disease has affected a large number of people in an area. A pandemic is the global version of an epidemic, where multiple regions are under attack. Between epidemic and endemic, the former means new cases are active and always exceed expectations. In simple terms, a problem that's out of control like the opioid epidemic, according to Intermountain Healthcare. The latter means constant presence, but new cases are always within expectations. Raina McIntyre, professor of global biosecurity at the University of New South Wales, said that COVID-19 isn't likely to become endemic anytime soon. Although an endemic disease could have very large numbers, the cases don't appear to change quickly in COVID-19. If case numbers do change with an endemic disease, it is slowly, typically over years. Epidemic diseases, on the other hand, rise rapidly over periods of days to weeks, McIntyre told CNBC. According to the Texas State Historical Association, there are many endemic diseases in the U.S. These include influenza, syphilis, and gonorrhea. Endemic diseases are always present in the country. However, they aren't unlikely to cause huge trouble for everyone. For example, gonorrhea isn't a typical agent of epidemic unless the bacteria has evolved and everyone else is doing risky behaviors simultaneously. Influenza, on the other hand, may start an epidemic if the virus mutates and many are vulnerable to it. So how do experts determine which disease is an epidemic? The R-naught measures how fast a disease is spreading. As of December 2021, experts at Imperial College London estimate that Omicron's R-naught is more than 3. It means a sick person can infect up to 3 other individuals. Those 3 other people can also infect 3 others each, putting the total to 13 people infected by the virus. It may seem small, but COVID-19 is a respiratory disease and doesn't require physical contact to spread. Coughing and sneezing are enough to fuel an epidemic. If the R-naught could be dragged down below 0, even with new variants around, then the view of COVID-19 as endemic might be considered. But right now, we've got our work cut out for us. Do you agree that COVID-19 won't become endemic anytime soon? Will you accept if we fail to eradicate the disease? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.